so scared. I'm so scared. I'm so scared. I'm so scared. Oh my God, the Leo's team. Oh my God, Leo's team. Ah, did y'all see my team prep video? There's, like, if you look at my face, if you listen to my voice, there's so much uncertainty that I'm speaking with, and now I'm feeling the pressure is literally in my chest. This chest that I'm banging right now is not, it's hollow. It is hollow. The only thing in this chest right now is my heart. It's like jumping all over. And man boobs. But mostly heart. Fight, Gators, fight, on the road to victory. Fight, Gators, fight, get a, just walk home with the win. Knock them out, crunch them all, show them how we Gators ball, wanna fight. Gators, fight, on the road to victory. V-G-A-T-R-S, Gators! Yeah, what's up, guys? PK Sparks here. Welcome to week 6 of the UCL versus the Durham Dreadigans. El Master Show Off. Leo. Oh, let's just get started. Now, I can't talk about it anymore. I just want to pick my music. Let's do music number 5. I don't think I've done 5 yet. Please select the music, the Pokemon you wish to enter. All right. So I'm going to show y'all my bio on screen real quick. We are rocking up with Gator, Fang the Garchomp, Pillowpet the Snorlax, Skarmory, Trevenant is, why isn't it named Lullaby? Whoops. And my mixtape, the Garboder. And Leo's team, he bought the Miltank. That's not what I wanted to see. He has Cresselia, he has Charizard, Miltank. He bought the Turtles, which I find interesting, but everything else, I'm fine with. He didn't bring the Thundurus! He didn't bring the Thundurus! Why didn't he bring the Thundurus? I bet you that that Turtles is Life Orb Sheer Force with Fire Blast from my Skarmory. I'm not gonna fall for that. I'm not gonna fall for that. Oh my God, he didn't bring the Thundurus! Why didn't he bring the Thundurus? I don't know why he wouldn't bring it. I'm going to be able to set up my spikes. 3 Pokemon are going to be immune to hazard, so I probably won't be worried about toxic spikes too. I need to make a choice. We're going to lead up with Garchomp. We're going to go with our initial plan. Get rocked up early so Charizard can't come in easy. Come on, Fang. Start it off with the Charizard. You scrub. Huh, I can't say that was a smart play. I'm gonna go for the Stone Edge. Let's see if he doesn't Mega Evolve immediately. If he doesn't, that's it. Please don't be that Impish set. Please don't be the Impish set. You're Impish Will-O-Wisp Roost, aren't you? I know he is. I'm so sad. I didn't bring Jinx for Hillbell. Even if I did, he withdraws immediately? Well, you know, I have the Yachi Berry. So if he goes to Ice Beam, I'm going to eat it up. I'm going for rocks. We're getting my rocks up on the field now. And unfortunately, because he has all these levitators, my Earthquake is definitely hindered. Until he gets rid of Charizard. I see you, you bloody little wanker. Unfortunately, something's going to get... Something will get paralyzed. What's about Trevin that had natural cure? What's I thought about that? Though I can come in on a status. But I didn't feel like he would, like, the only thing that could really thunderwave me is this thing. I need to toxic it now, but I don't want to go out in the Garbodor right now. I want to catch him off guard with that. So let's switch out to Trevenant. Can Trevenant take an Ice Beam? I feel like he can. And then with the moveset, I have leftovers on me. He didn't bring Azumarill either. He didn't bring a lot of Pokemon that I was expecting. We're going to swap out here. I don't want to take an Ice Beam right now. I need him later on for damage. Trevenant is kind of expendable. Frisk. Cobra Berry. What the heck does that do? Cobra Berry. Bulbapedia. What does that do? Doesn't say what it does. If Hellbound Pokemon is buried, will lessen the effect of dark type attacks. He wants to paralyze my Gator. You cheeky little wanker. With Cobra Berry. I knew Frisk was a good idea. Psychic and Thunder Wave is on this thing. It's going to drop a burn. Oh, he's withdrawing. If he goes out in a Charizard, I'm looking at Mojado. He is expecting lead seat. He is expecting lead seat. He was expecting lead seat. He was expecting lead seat. Ow, 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 ow. I said let's go. He was expecting lead seat, but he ain't get it. Get burned. Get burned. Get burned. I said get burned, me a little bit, huh? Alright. Alright, we're gonna drop this Protect real quick. I have seen some silly sets run by this Rotom, Rotom when I've been watching his battles. You guys don't understand. Whenever I'm going to battle somebody, I watch like the last 2-3 battles. So, we're gonna Protect. We're gonna see what he does. Please use Trick. We know he's not leftovers. That's the thing. He's not leftovers. He just went for Will-O-Wisp. Is this another check for Gator? Is he afraid of Gator as well? He has two checks for Gator. Good thing I'm not bringing him in until late game. But who do I want to bring in? Everybody on my team won't appreciate a burn. We're out in the mixtape. Mixtape is the most expendable. I don't expect Gunkshot to be doing much anyway. There's the Wisp. Alright, man, you got that. Fortunately, I didn't have a fire type in my my Talonflame. It's over easy for him to not have gone for that, you know? So we're gonna drop this Toxic Spikes. Mojado. I'm fine with that. So another thing is going to be Eviolite. It gets knockoff, right? Pretty sure it gets knockoff. So he wants to knock something off. He doesn't have Drapion, so I can set up two layers of spikes. That way, the Miltank, the Charizard if he Mega Evolves, the Tauros, they're not going to appreciate it. I hate how many Levitators he has. Dang. But you know what? We're going to go for it anyway. Two layers of Toxic Spikes. Defog. Forgot about that. Completely forgot about that. I said that and I completely forgot. Fair enough, dude. You got that. And I'm sure his ability... Let me look up Gligar's other ability. Like, maybe it'll be feasible for him to at least try it. I know he gets immunity. And to be honest, why wouldn't you want to put immunity on a wall? Sandville or Hypercutter? No. He has immunity. We are getting behind. I should have went out in the Garchomp. Would have been an immediate threat. Alright, so what we're going to do is go back out into Trevenant. Hopefully he doesn't knock off. If he does knock off, we'll catch it, but that's going to be pretty much it. He could go for default again. Not wanting spikes up. If you're right, okay. Goes to default. Does not want spikes up. So right now, I'm going to go for Leech Seed. If he goes out into my Mahalo, he's going to come in and get 12.5% damage. And then I'm going to protect anyway to get 12.5% more. So there's going to be damage on his Rotom. Mo, if it or Rotom Cut, if that dude come in. If it doesn't come in, well, then I'm gonna get an HP back thanks to Leech Seed. So that's the plan right now. Unless he uses Taunt. Alright. Shadow Claw. Just do damage. Knock off. It's all good. His entire, like, out of my entire team, I wanted him to catch a knockoff the most. Oh my god, I know he has Roost. His team. This makes me sad. I want to burn that thing. I can't do nothing to it. Pillowpet has to come out. He's the only Pokemon I have that can be a threat to this Gligar. Unfortunately, he has to come out. Trevenant can't do anything. Yep, he's free to just knock off continuously. So any reason why I wouldn't want to go for Ice Punch? Miltank could have, it is pretty early. Ice Punch and Charizard are just gonna laugh. Well, Ice Punch, I'm sorry, Miltank could pretty much laugh at it. Cresselia as well. Let's go for Body Slam because it's still pretty early. Let's get guaranteed damage. If I can get Prowls right now, that'd be sweet. Nope, I'm not that lucky. He knocked me off, he taunted me. Would he want to go for, I feel like he want to go for Roost right now. That's why we went for Body Slam. We went for Body Slam, just to get some extra damage still. And I don't want to expose my my Ice Punch too soon. No paralysis. I could keep going for Body Slam. Let's expose it. Let's go for Ice Punch. He goes for knockoff. This thing is annoying. See, without knocking an item off, knockoff does not do anything. Now what you gonna do, Leo? And my taunt were off. Now the question is, do I have curse or not? Body Slam will do enough. So we're gonna go for Body Slam here. If he goes for Roost, then we'll have another chance for paralysis. He goes for Roost. Oh my god. Oh, Leo. Paralysis. No. Alright, because he's at half, I'm not gonna go for Ice Punch. I'm gonna keep going for Body Slam. Is this all he's going to do? Leo, you stalling wanker. Paralysis. No! 30% chance! 4 times! No paralysis. Sweet. Okay. I might be playing a little predictable here. I probably should've went for Body Slam again. And not Ice Punch. I should've went for Body Slam again. That was my fault. Hopefully I can get lucky with a freeze. Yep, Miltank coming in. On the plus side, he just revealed to me that he's thick fat and not scrappy. Remember what I was saying in my team build video? Remember what I was saying in my team build video? this defense of his, man. This is what everyone's been talking about, and they're just like, he's lame for it. Now I know. Now I understand. We are going to go for Leech Seed again. I need some HP back. And if he goes for, to Rotom, he's already burnt. So he has to heal Bell right now to save his Rotom. Which means I'm going to get a pretty hefty amount of HP back. And then I'm just going to go for Willows the next turn. He can't touch me. Assuming that he doesn't have, like, Iron Tail or Earthquake, something like that, he can't touch me. Yo, imagine if Miltank's hidden ability was normalized. Now that'd be a good ability. Like, not many Pokemon have normalized. I mean, no, you can't do normalize a Scrappy. Never mind. Stealth Rock. I don't think that's a problem for me. What is this Miltank? Can this not happen? Can this not happen? Oh, that's so dumb. I went for the burn. Shoot. Ah! Dang it! Forgot about that Charizard in the back. I forgot my own darn strategy. I'm stupid, man. It's not over yet, I know this. I'm going straight for Toxic instead of Toxic Spikes. I can paralyze or poison anybody on his team, barring Gligar. I saw Gligar on the field, I really should have went at it, but I just didn't want to get knocked off. But I knew he was going to go for Defog, I knew it. Why didn't I just go for like Waterfall or something? Like go out in the Gator, be a threat. I mean, I would have went for Ice Punch because he still has that Voltron cut. Flare Blitz. So if it KOs, he's gonna take big damage from Aftermath. Don't KO. Dang it! On the plus side, we should be able to KO him with Dragon Claw right now. Actually, we should KO with Earthquake. No, let's go for Dragon Claw. Dragon Claw will hit anybody. Dragon Claw will hit anybody. I know he knows it's coming. I'm not going to go for anything else. This Charizard X needs to go. It took out two of my mons with Dragon Claw and Flare Blitz. Although, fortunately, he does have half health. He could go for Roost, but I'm going to outspeed him. I'm pretty sure I have enough speed to outspeed the Charizard. Pretty sure I do. I believe I made my speed 329 and put the rest in defense so I could take a Dragon Claw, hopefully. There's no way he's scarfed. He doesn't have a Dragon Dance up. Which, personally, I would have done on my Garbodor instead of just one-shotting it. That way he can deal with my Garchomp. Because there's nothing the Garbodor can get against Mega Charizard X besides Earthquake, but that wouldn't have one-shot, especially with a burn. Just nothing. I definitely would have Dragon Dance if I was him. He's gonna withdraw. Okay. gonna get rocks up. He's gonna go for Ice Beam. We're gonna eat it up thanks to Yachi. Ice Beam? Psychic. Okay. Does it not have Ice Beam? Oh, right now we are withdrawing on Skarmory. I want to try and get ahead and drop Toxic on this thing, because I know he's going to be like, what's the thing going to do? I'm just going to paralyze it. I just want to Toxic to Cresselia. I know he can stall with Moonlight, but... I told you guys, if I get swept, don't be shocked. His team is, like, so hard for me to deal with. It really is. And I made a couple misplays myself already. Like, when the Gligar was out, I should have went out, like, knowing Defog was coming. I said it in the build video. Why didn't I remember it now? I need to really think. Like, right now, I'm getting ahead of myself. I'm getting antsy trying to figure it out. But I really need to get ahead and think about what he's going to do. I need Chomp Around for X. Psychic, I'll take that. I just hope it doesn't go out in the Gligar. I'm not trying to do no Star War. I'm gonna drop this Toxic right now. Hopefully he went in the Gligar, didn't he? No tank. No, that was Gligar. Wow. And he avoided it? Wait, he avoided it? Now he's immune? Okay, if it would have hit, see, now I don't know. If it would have hit, I know he's going to go for Defog. But if I mess this up, there's two sides to this. His Rotom C already took a lot of damage, but I'm going to be losing my knockoff. This is a risk. Like, I know he wants to bring that Garchomp, the Zard, in safe, especially after already going down in yellow. I don't have Whirlwind. I wish I had this thing burnt. Because if I had it burnt, then I could just go for spikes and it would have to keep defogging or let the Zard, you know, come in on spikes at least. So, I feel like I need to change momentum. Hopefully he doesn't go for knockoff. If he does, we're screwed. I hope that he's banking his entire game on that Zard with Tauros to clean up. Please do not go for knockoff. I'll take it. I will take it. I will take it. I gotta see. I gotta count this real quick. God, I hate his team. God, I hate his team! Ice Punch will do 73%. Wait, I'm gonna change the levels. So 73.2. 76 actually, so it does more now. That should be enough to KO. That's minimum. We're going for Ice Punch. He doesn't outspeed. We're going for Ice Punch. We're hitting something. We are hitting something. We are hitting something. The question is what? We're going for Ice Punch. Ice Punch is going to hit the only thing it won't do damage to is the Miltank. Can't Miltank? He does withdraw. I feel like Miltank can get Thunder Wave. No, I just feel like he can. That feels like a Miltank thing. it can get Thunderwave. Good thing is I kept my Vox up. Reveal Thunderwave. Body Slam. I'm about to get paralyzed. No paralysis? Okay. I can't do anything to his team though. His team is just so incredibly bulky. Oh my god. Oh my god, I can't do anything to his team. I only have decent bulk. He has tremendous bulk. God dang it! Now the Mojado is healed. He's gonna stay and go for Milk Drink now. That means that he doesn't have Thunder Wave though. That means that he doesn't have Thunder Wave. So if I can get a little lucky, if he brings in Miltank again, or on Gator, I can go for Dragon Dance and see what happens. Milk Drink. I freaking hate Leo. I hate Leo so much. Oh my god, his team is so bulky! Oh. God dang it! I wish I gave somebody unexpected toxic. I can't keep switching out because I gotta hope for a crit. This is one of those times where I'm just gonna stay in. If I don't get paralyzed. The Miltank's in danger. He has to swap out. Does he think he'll live another earthquake? Can I KO? If I don't swap out, what's the risk? Should I go for a Dragon Claw expecting him to swap out? I'm gonna go for Dragon Claw. I'm gonna try to bank on a crit or get max damage. He knows that he can't live another earthquake at this range. He might go for Body Slam just for the KO, assuming he will. But I wanna do damage to his Miltank. If he does stay in, then maybe with the Rough Skin damage, he'll go out. He'll KO himself. Worst case scenario, he goes for Milk Drain, and I don't KO. Which is back to the start, and I go for Earthquake. So I'm gonna go for Dragon Claw. Should've just went for the KO. But the Rotom, the Cresselia, the Gligar, which is what I'm most worried about. I don't want him to bring in Gligar on a safe switch. God dang it! I hate his team. I hate his team. Screw you, Leo. Screw you, dude. It's just bulk. And I can't swap out anymore because he does have locked up in my field. I hate this match. I hate this match just because of the mods he has, and it's not his fault, you know? Like, I just, my team isn't built for it. I should have bought Hitmonchan. Hitmonchan could have done a lot. Then again, he would have done a lot. I don't have any special attackers barring Sceptile, but the typing risk was too real. My only chance now I gotta go to Gator and Dragon Dance and hope I can get a Switch. If I can't get two Dragon Dances up right now, it's game. I know that Cresselia has that Cobra Berry, so I'm gonna go for Waterfall. He swaps out immediately. All I can do at this point, and I don't have any other choice. I need to go. Like, he's gonna go for that Thunder Wave. And all I can do is let him. Hopefully I can get a crit, one shot with his Waterfall, most likely. I'm assuming he's scarfed. I'm gonna go out in the Trevenant. I'm assuming that he's scarfed. We're gonna go out in the Trevenant. And we're gonna find out for sure right now. He has to be scarfed. And I know he wants to just one-shot me with a Thunderbolt. I can't let that. Or a Leaf Storm. I can't let that. Trevenant is the reason why. Volum Cut is the reason why Trevenant is here. If he goes for Wisp. Actually, I wonder if I could have outsped that thing. I probably should have checked that. Let's go check that right now. I probably just made a grave mistake. Is it Voltum Cut or Voltum Mo? That's one question I want to know. Bars. .298, no. I could not speed. Even with one Dragon Dance, I could not speed. Who did I take out? I took out the Cress. Charizard's coming out. I'm gonna go straight for Shadow Claw, assuming he wants to go for Roost. I could go for Leech Seed though, because he's gonna outspeed me. This could be the best chance to get Shadow Claw Roost up. Leech Seed. So I already know his team is Bulky F. So let's assume he's gonna go for Roost. If he goes for Flare Blitz, that is a dead Zard. If he goes for, well, Dragon Claw might KO me. No, I shouldn't. There's no reason why he shouldn't go for Roost, in my opinion. Just get that HP back on that Zard. I don't want to switch in Gator anymore. Unless I have to. I guess I have to. I'm gonna go out in the Skarmory. He has to Flare Blitz me. He has to Flare Blitz me. I hate his team. He won. He's gonna go out into Rotom C and just go for Leaf Storm. And that's gonna be the ball game. Leo's team was just way too bulky. Like, I put up my best. I kinda misplayed with Snorlax. But in the end, his team was just way too bulky. That Miltank and Gligar did a lot more than what I would have appreciated. It really did. Fortunately, I don't need to go for... actually, I could stand to go for Dragon Dance again, but I can't risk it. I'm going to go for Ice Punch. She's going to go for Lee Storm. That's going to be it. Or Volt Switch. I'm only disappointed because I feel like I stood no chance from the beginning. I did my best. I did misplay a little bit. But I feel like I stood no chance from the very beginning. Like I told you guys, his team is really bulky. There's Megazord X, the Miltank, the Tauros, the Gligar, and the Rotom. His team, and the Cresselia. His team is just bulky and can still do damage. Like, there was too much on his team I had to prepare for that I couldn't. He had status, he had bulk, he had strength, he had typing, he had levitate. Like, there was just taunt as well. There was too much on his team for one mind to deal with. So unfortunately, we lose this week and our winning streak of only two games comes to an end. I really want to get out of this slump of like going back and forth. I don't want that. So the goal is to win our next three battles. Let's go on and find out who our next three battles are against. Let's see now. We're going to go to the UCL Twitter. Twitter.com/UCLOfficial. Alright, so Durham's run against us out the way. Oh, shoot. We have the South Beach Slow Kings coached by Sensational GP. We have the New York Mankeys coached by Shady Penguin. And we have the Tulsa Talent Flames coached by Kristen. We have to beat them. We have to beat them. I don't like our score being like this. I really want to be positive right now. Like, we haven't gone negative. We've gone negative once. We've been negative twice, actually. We went 1-2, and then 2-2, and now we're 3-2, and then now we're 3-3. I don't know. Just please don't be mad at me. Like I told you guys at the very beginning, this team was bulky. And if I get handled, please just forgive me. I didn't have the tools to deal with this team. I still think it's shocking that he didn't bring Thundurus, but I mean, he just 4-0'd me. I can't say anything about his team because it clearly got him to win. Ah, well. Tomorrow's another day. Next week is another week. And at the end of the day, the beginning of a new day, what are the Gators going to do? Fight. Thank you all so much for watching. If you guys enjoyed the video, don't forget to demolish that like button for me. Not just if you enjoyed it, but to support the Gators as well. Let me know you guys still have my back. And I'll see you guys for week 7 of the UCL. Thank you all very much for watching. Stay hot, guys. And I'll see y'all next time.